One physical phenomenon that is sometimes factored into the illumination model is described by the Fresnel equations. These equations were discovered by the French engineer and physicist Augustin Jean Fresnel. He received little recognition of his work in optics while he was alive. Much of it was published after his death in 1827. Happily, what evidently gave him the most pleasure was the discovery and experimental confirmation of a scientific theory. The Fresnel equations themselves have to do with the amount of reflection and refraction off a surface. The basic relationship is this: the more on edge you look at a surface, the more reflective it is. If the surface is refractive, in other words transparent, the amount of light transmitted will drop off considerably as you approach this shallow angle. My favorite example is a lake or the ocean. The next time you're in shallow water, notice that you can look straight down and see the bottom. As you look out towards the horizon, the angle of your eye to the surface's normal approaches 90 degrees and reflection will dominate. For materials that aren't transparent, this effect still takes place. The Fresnel effect is particularly noticeable for what are called dielectrics, which is a fancy way of saying insulators. In other words, materials such as glass, plastic, and clay. For example, glass is about 25 times as reflective at a shallow angle than directly head-on. An experiment you can do right now to prove this to yourself. Take a sheet of normal paper, nothing very shiny or rough, and put it on a flat surface such as a book. Hold the paper so that you're holding it nearly edge-on and look towards a lit area such as a window. Here I'm using the tablet. At nearly 90 degrees to the surface normal, you'll see the paper become quite reflective. In fact, the Fresnel effect should also lessen the diffuse contribution. As the object becomes more reflective in real life, there are less photons left to go off in other directions. There's one implementation detail I want to mention. You should use the normal that represents the mirror orientation. For example, for a mirror reflective surface, this is simply the shading normal. For most other materials, it's not. With the Blinn-Fong illumination equation, the idea is that the material is made of microfacets. Only a few facets are angled just right to reflect light towards the eye. These facets have normal vectors pointing exactly halfway between the light and eye vectors. Recall that this special direction is called the half-angle vector. Happily, this is a vector we compute anyway for specular highlighting, but it's important to use this direction and not the shading normal. Try the demo to get a sense of the effect. Notice how a nearly edge-on angle causes the reflectivity to increase.